Good afternoon and welcome everybody to today's HLAA webinar. We are titled here Innovations in Individualized Cochlear Implants by MED-EL. Thank you for joining us again today. My name is Alex Cooper. I'm with the HLAA and I'm your host today. Today's presentation is being recorded and will be available for playback at a later time at the HLAA website at hearingloss.org. Also our YouTube channel. I will start by giving us some quick tech tips on the webinar today. You can turn on captions for this webinar and you will need to click on the CC icon at the bottom of your screen and click on Show Subtitles. You can also change the font size for your subtitles in the subtitle settings. Chat is available for this, but only for technical issues and the panelists only. We please encourage the participants of this webinar to use the Q&A icon to ask questions, which Laura herself will be taking at the end of her presentation. We will be using it also to facilitate any additional questions, and it will be recorded, so any information from HLAA can come after the webinar if required. If you've joined by your computer, the presentation should be in side-by-side mode. Slides are on the left and panelists are on the right in the gallery view. You can change the size of your side-by-side view by hovering between the two screens and moving the gray bar to adjust to your desired size. If you've joined by mobile device or phone, your view may be slightly different and you may have to scroll between views to find your desired one. Finally, this is a disclaimer from the HLAA. Just to let you know that we do not endorse this product featured in the webinar. HLAA is providing an educational opportunity to learn about this product and how it can benefit people with hearing loss. Our presenter today is Laura Cochran, Consumer Engagement Manager at MED-EL. Laura, I'll turn the presentation over to you. Feel free to share your presentation.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm just going to get our screen set up for you. There we go. Alex, you let me know that everything looks good. Okay.
Looks good. Excellent. Thank you, Laura.
Awesome. Thank you. Well, welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me today. My name is Laura Cochran. I'm a trilingual speech language pathologist and consumer engagement manager with MED-EL. MED-EL is one of three FDA-approved cochlear implant manufacturers in the U.S. For MED-EL, I cover most of the Midwest region, so I'm coming to you live from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, where I live, and I'm also part of our bilingual Spanish outreach program, which is called Unidos Oímos. I'm really honored to be with you today to talk about some really exciting innovations, and thanks very much to the HLAA team for having me. All right, let's go. These are just my quick disclosures. I work for MED-EL. I also volunteer on a nonprofit board in the Chicagoland area. At MED-EL, our mission is really to eliminate hearing loss as a barrier to communication and quality of life. And we do that by providing a variety of intact skin hearing solutions and providing a really wide spectrum of supports to patients, their families, and their hearing health professionals. So your audiologists, your ENTs. Historically, the products that we've offered have always covered a very wide range of hearing loss profiles. And I'm really excited to share with you today some innovations on how we are tailoring those offerings to be more customized, more individualized than they've ever been before. We're going to focus today primarily on our cochlear implant system, which I'll show you in just a moment, but MED-EL offers other products as well so that your audiogram doesn't have to hold you back from a solution and from an improved quality of life. Hand in hand with the devices, the equipment that we make, we also offer technical support, rehabilitation resources, which is so important when you're using hearing amplification and technology. We have expert clinical support and a huge, caring, passionate community of recipients who are eager to connect with others. I know I recognize some names in our participant list today. So we're really here to make sure that you and your families are covered with support. So again, regardless of your hearing loss type and really severity, MED-EL offers a hearing solution. So you can see there's three different products here, really four sort of. Over here, you can see the cochlear implant system. So the implant itself, you can see in both of these images. And then we have two different processor styles, the Sonnet 2 and the Rondo 3, which is laying flat like it's on a table. And then we also offer an electric acoustic system, that's EAS, which is a combination of hearing aid and cochlear implant technologies. So that uses the same implant as a typical cochlear implant system, but the Sonnet 2 processor uses an ear mold and is able to function as both a hearing aid and a cochlear implant. We also offer a bone conduction implant system that's called the Bone Bridge. And the processor that's worn externally is called the Samba 2. And then we also have the Adhere system, which was revolutionary as a non-invasive bone conduction device. So there's no surgery involved with Adhere. There's an adhesive that's worn just behind the ear on the skin, and then a processor that clicks into that adhesive. I'd highlight as well, one thing that's very unique about MED-EL is that all three of these devices, all three of these systems that you see here are currently approved by the FDA and Health Canada for single-sided deafness, so a unilateral hearing loss. Depending on your specific hearing loss configuration, each one of these systems has some distinct advantages, but they are all approved for that type of hearing loss. I won't go into criteria for candidacy for all of these systems in too much detail. I want to quickly review them. As a reminder, criteria for hearing technology, implants, hearing aids, all of that really varies both by manufacturer and also by market. So what I'm showing you and discussing today is going to be specific to FDA approvals for MED-EL in the United States. And I wanted to share this information with you so that you have an idea of what kinds of audiograms work with different systems, but we're not going to go into a ton of detail. The reason for that is that if you are not satisfied with your current hearing status, whether that is using your residual hearing and you're not using any amplification, or maybe you're using hearing aids and you're feeling like they're just not getting you where you want to be, if you're feeling frustrated and you're wondering if there's another technology option for you, the best place to start is to get a full hearing evaluation from a qualified medical team. Several factors determine whether or not someone is an appropriate candidate for lots of these technologies. So it's really important that you're evaluated by an experienced audiologist and or ENT surgeon to determine what might be appropriate for you. MED-EL is happy to assist you in finding a center of excellence in your local area so you can get started with that process if you're not sure where to go. But again, what's really unique about our products is that they're here for everybody from someone with a mild hearing loss, single-sided deafness, profound sensory neural hearing loss. We have options that can be suited to you, and we're really here to guide you at every step of the way. At the end of the presentation today, I have some contact information. I'll also put my personal contact information in the chat if you want to reach me personally, but we're really here to help. At MED-EL, we have a long history of lots of firsts in the industry. So going back to the late 1970s, when the first multi-channel cochlear implant was developed, to the late 90s, when we came out with the first wearing option for young children, to the early 2000s, when we came out with the first electrode that was designed for preserving those delicate structures in the cochlea. We came out with the first single unit processor with the Rondo in 2003. You can see, where is it? It's not, there we go, 2013, I'm sorry. And then our first MRI safe magnet in the industry in 2014. So we have a long history of firsts and a really strong, consistent focus on innovations. So I'm really excited to talk to you about what is coming out next. Well, it's out now. It's ready for you. So the latest excitement in our neck of the woods is a surgical planning software that's called Otoplan and a programming tool for audiologists called anatomy-based fitting. Together, these two tools really offer recipients an individualized, customized cochlear implant experience. So I'm gonna zoom out and talk to you a little bit about how cochlear implants work, and then we'll get into the nitty-gritty of what these two new technologies are. So very often, when patients are considering their device options, naturally they kind of fast forward to how they're going to be able to stream from a smartphone or connect to a laptop. How are they going to use this with their families? Sort of what are the benefits? Of course, that's the natural place that we all want to go when we're considering such a significant health decision. Of course, connectivity is critical in today's day and age. We are all together today using various forms of connectivity and technology. But when you're embarking on this lifelong hearing healthcare decision, we cannot overlook the foundational component of the decision, which is the implant itself. So Dr. Carol Flexer, who is a world-renowned audiologist, auditory verbal therapist out of Ohio, she says that all cochlear implants are brain-developing tools, and I just love that. So I want to review some of the information about how a cochlear implant gets auditory information to the brain. This is a very technicolor photo of a cochlea. Of course, in real life, it's not purple and neon green, but I like the visibility that these colors show you, and it shows you how in your cochlea, these hair cells transcend all 2.5 turns into our snail shell shaped cochlea. The electrode array of a cochlear implant system is the part that is surgically inserted to bypass any damaged or missing hair cells so that we can stimulate the auditory nerve directly. In natural hearing, there's three components of sound: loudness, timing, and pitch. And all of that information is encoded as a sound that reaches each ear and travels up to your brain, okay? For cochlear implant users, the ability to discriminate, tell the differences between sounds and perceive loudness, timing, and pitch relative to folks with natural hearing is gonna vary pretty significantly by the input that they receive from their technology. Okay. The ears are the doorway to the brain. And so we want to make sure that the signal that a cochlear implant user receives from their technology is clear. If a signal is muddy going in, it's going to be muddy coming out. Loudness, timing, and pitch are these critical, measurable components of speech that contribute to how humans perceive tone. Tone of voice. Why is tone of voice so important? Well, if you think about it, being able to perceive small differences in loudness, timing, and pitch changes tonal variations in our speech that can impact emotional content, the feeling behind our words, that can indicate humor and sarcasm. There are whole languages that use tone information to change meaning, where truly just a change in the pitch of your voice changes the meaning of one word or the tense of a verb. It's really how we derive meaning from speech. Historically, cochlear implants did a pretty good job with loudness and timing, and we did our best with pitch. But I want to talk about how now we can encode these things differently than we've ever been able to before. You guys have probably seen some variation of this image in a doctor's office or online, maybe as you're doing research on hearing. So what you can see here is the audio processor being worn externally, connecting to the implant via a magnet right here, and then the coil has a magnet on the inside. So sound travels across the microphones from the processor, it's digitized, and sent across the skin to the receiver stimulator of the implant, where the electrode array, which is threaded into the cochlea, breaks down that signal and delivers it to the different parts of the cochlea. What I want to show you is this video that I really love, because this shows you what the implant actually is in 3D. This is MED-EL's electrode array going into a cochlea. And it shows you this is really what's delivering the signal to your auditory nerve, to your brain. So each of these dark spots along the wire, you can see really wavy wires connecting. These are the electrode contacts. And that's how deep into the apex of the cochlea the electrode array goes. We're going to talk more about that in a minute. So going back to our elements of sound, let's talk about pitch. The hair cells in the cochlea, you remember that purple and neon green photo I showed you, they're organized tonotopically. So what that means is your cochlea is basically organized like a rolled up piano keyboard. The hair cells, those neon green hair cells you saw in that image, that are sensitive to the highest pitch sounds are out here at the base of the cochlea. And then as we go deeper into the cochlea, hair cells that are sensitive to the lowest pitch sounds are here at the top or the apex of the cochlea, okay? Historically, the motivation for pursuing a cochlear implant was to get access to sound, specifically speech, that hearing aids couldn't provide. That was a huge factor in determining whether someone is an appropriate candidate for an implant, right? If they've reached the limits of what even the highest power hearing aids can do for them, that's usually a sign that a cochlear implant may be a possibility for them. I think an even better goal than just access to sound would be, to use Dr. Flexer's term, to develop a listening brain by using cochlear implant technology to mimic natural hearing as closely as possible. So that's our new goal, to develop the listening brain by using cochlear implant technology to mimic natural hearing as closely as we can. And if that's the goal, to mimic natural hearing, then we have to mimic the anatomy of the cochlea with the cochlear implant technology. In order to reach all of those hair cells that correspond to high pitches and low pitches accurately, it's going to be critical that we have an electrode array that's long enough to reach all of these nerve structures from the base of the cochlea to the apex, so that when you're stimulating that implant, we're putting stimulation in the right place. The place where the implant electrode array responds is where those cells would respond naturally, okay? So to provide that rich, natural sounding sound quality, we have to mimic that natural hearing cochlea and cover it with as much of the electrode array as we can. At MED-EL, we often say we want to cover the whole piano. We don't want to stop short and miss some of those octaves. So we agreed on this new goal, right? We want to mimic the anatomy of the cochlea with our technology so that we can reach all of those hair cells that correspond with high and low pitches using that long electrode array that puts the stimulation in the right place. Just like a piano, if you only had half of the keys on your keyboard, if we use an electrode array that's too short to reach the apex of that cochlea, that can result in unnatural, unsatisfactory sound quality. That's sometimes where we hear reports of, oh yeah, you know, my implant's pretty good, but everybody sounds like Darth Vader. Everybody sounds like Mickey Mouse. You can understand Darth Vader and you can understand Mickey Mouse, but those are probably not vocal qualities that you want all of the people in your life to sound like every day. So How does MED-EL help surgeons maximize their ability to pick the right array to reflect the length of the patient's cochlea? Now we're going to pull all this together, okay? Otoplan is this new way to unlock data that, as an industry, we previously didn't have access to. It's a way to customize and individualize the cochlear implant experience. What we've learned from using this planning software is that no patient is alike. Every person, every ear, even between ears in the same patient, every cochlea is different. And so your own left cochlea might be a different size than your own right cochlea. All the more reason that your cochlear implant should be tailored to meet the specific needs and offer you the closest to natural hearing. So with this technology, we kind of move away from one size fits all philosophy that historically we used for a very long time in our industry towards truly individualizing medicine. Because cochleas vary so much in length, remember we talked about it's like a rolled up keyboard. So when we talk about length, we're talking about if we unrolled your cochlea, how long would that duct be? They vary in shape, they vary in height. MED-EL offers surgeons multiple options of electrode arrays. They're all gentle, they're all very safe. And the idea is like, you know, you have different sized feet for different sized shoes. So it would make sense that if you have different sized cochlea, we have different sized electrode arrays, okay? What's the best fit for one patient won't necessarily be the best fit for the next patient, even if it's that same patient's other ear. So it's important to have options. And with Otoplan, now surgeons have the information to decide more accurately which length is the best fit for that ear. So how does this work? Otoplan is a surgical planning software. So this is something that your hospital team would use. They use standard imaging, so an MRI or a CT scan, to produce a 3D map with parameters of your unique cochlea prior to your implant surgery. It's an on-demand service. It's really easy to use. A cochlear implant team would upload an MRI or a CT scan using MED-EL's HIPAA-compliant, very secure, safe platform. And then the cochlear implant team can get a accurate 3D model of your cochlea, which allows your surgeon to select which flex electrode will best fit your unique inner ear. The MRI or the CT that they're uploading can be completely anonymous, can be completely de-identified prior to sending to MED-EL. So this is a very safe, secure, private process. So let's pull some of this together. We talked about different parts of your cochlea are responsible for sounds at different pitches. When the electrode array covers that whole cochlea and stimulates it at the right location for that pitch, we can get closer to natural sound quality. Okay, that's going to be our goal. I talked about the other piece of this. Anatomy-based fitting is an option for your audiologist after surgery, where they can then pinpoint the exact position of each electrode contact in your ear and adjust the programming of your processor to complement the fit of that electrode. So this is right in line with our goal of wanting you to hear each and every piano key and have that like full, rich, natural sound quality with your system. So this complements Otoplan and is used by the audiologists. These are some of the references for some of the data that we've talked about today. I want to very quickly, because I know we're coming up on time, just highlight the group of professionals that is out there from our team waiting to help you. We have hundreds of years of clinical experience. Every one of us is a speech pathologist, audiologist, teacher of the deaf, an auditory verbal therapist, some combination of those credentials. We have folks who speak multiple languages. We're really here to support you. If you are a MED-EL recipient, we have a huge variety of resources that are waiting for you. So this support, as I mentioned, does not stop at surgery or once your processor is activated. We have a really big community of recipients who are also ready to connect with you and share their experiences. And if you have questions, write this down. I'll put in the Q&A. I think I can write in there. Oh, I can't write in there. If you reach out to us at either this 800 number or this implants@medelus.com email address, you'll be able to connect with me directly. We're here if you need a clinic, if you have questions, if you are a MED-EL recipient with questions about any of your equipment, we're here to help. So reach out to us here and we'll make sure you get connected with folks. And with that, I'm going to stop sharing and look at your questions and answers. I see there's a few in the chat. Okay. Some folks needing support. Okay, I'm seeing have had my MED-EL unit for years. Okay, folks needing help with their MED-EL equipment. Here's what I would say. Reach out to us at implants@medelus.com. And let us know that you need help. We have one-on-one Zoom calls with our community technical support audiologists where they can hop on a Zoom with you captioned privately to go over any of your questions at all. We can go over how you use any parts of your accessories or your equipment. I see the other questions are from the same person about similar equipment questions. So I will reach out to you, my lovely question asker. I'm writing down your name so I can reach out to you directly to get you some of those answers. We do have a mobile app that replaced the fine tuner remote control. It's called Audio Key 2. So that may be an option out there for you. And I can talk to you about water wear as well for waterproofs options for your processors. What specifically does the audiologist use the electrode location info that the anatomy-based system offers? Okay, so for anatomy-based fitting, instead of using an algorithm in the programming software to figure out where those pitches occur and trying to program using an algorithm, the audiologists are able to see exactly where your electrode contacts sit in your cochlea, and they can adjust some of the frequency bands to be stimulated where your electrical contacts sit in your cochlea, if that makes any sense. That takes a post-op CT scan to do, but that's definitely something that you can talk to your audiologist about. If they have questions, you can connect them with their MED-EL team. They're very familiar with us. We can walk them through that information as well. But with that, I think we are just about out of time. So, Alex, I'm going to kick it back over to you.
Thank you, Laura. Just to let you know, if you'd like to put that contact information anywhere, you should be able to use the chat function to send it to everyone.
Oh, perfect. I will put my email in there right now.
Okay, no problem. Well, thank you, everyone. I can see there's a couple of extra questions. I will make sure that those get to Laura individually.
Thank you.
We, again, thank you to Laura. Thank you to MED-EL today for presenting the showcase webinar. We appreciate your time. Thank you also to Brandy Kent, who is our captioneer today. Thank you very much for the services. Just to let you know that this webinar will be recorded and will be posted to the HLAA website, as well as our YouTube channel. Please check our website, hearingloss.org, for any future webinars and other webinar recordings as well. And thank you for joining us, everyone. You have a great day. Thank you again for joining the webinar.
Thank you.